In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step the many erasing operations, and in particular, what the eraser tool is, what it does, and its features in MS Paint. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We opened MS Paint and saw a clean and blank canvas. The eraser is located under the Tools tab in the main section. We can erase it with the eraser tool or change the color according to the background color. First, on our blank canvas, we freely draw the letter E with the pen tool. We have deliberately overextended some parts of the letter E, and now we would remove the extra parts with the eraser tool. If we change the background color or the second color to black, the eraser can now work as if it were painting black on a surface other than black. Thanks to this feature, we can use the eraser tool for alternative painting and color changes, which we will show in the next step. We can also use the eraser tool as a sculptor's tool, a tool for two-dimensional modeling, shaping, image manipulation, as we demonstrated with the pen tool in the previous lesson. The eraser tool has four settings ready in the size section, and the size settings are, of course, not limited to this. To access more size options, we can use the key combination Control and Plus as a shortcut. With the eraser tool selected, we increase its size with the key combination Control and Plus, and decrease it with the key combination Control and Minus. To show the eraser tool, and its dimensions more effectively, we cover part of our canvas with a black foreground color. For this, we first make it completely black with the bucket tool, and then collapse it with the box in the center of the far right edge of our canvas. By the way, our background color is white, so when we expand our canvas again, it will automatically fill the expanded empty space with the background color, which is an alternative deletion method. Now we can start showing all the dimensions of the eraser tool, one below the other, starting from the top left corner of our canvas. We zoomed the screen at the last level and activated the grids in the view section to see the pixels more clearly. As we mentioned before, with the eraser tool selected, we increase its size with the key combination Control and Plus. Our step-by-step iterative process continues, and we can now show all thickness options and sizes in an accelerated format to save time. After a level, the size will no longer increase for the eraser tool. There is a size scale from a minimum of 1 pixel to a maximum of 50 pixels. Earlier we mentioned that we can use erase operations to manipulate shapes or images. For different image manipulations, we can perform basic operations such as adding or subtracting and deleting from the shape. We can record our work up to this point if we wish. Next, we will provide examples of many more different features and uses of the eraser tool. We change the second color, also known as the background color, to yellow and make some scribbles with the eraser tool. We continue to assign other colors as background colors. The most important point for the eraser tool is that it works according to the background color. Changing color with the right mouse button only affects the foreground color. But if we erase with the left mouse button, it will erase whatever color is on the surface. If the surface is already the same as the background color, it will remain the same as there will be no change, but it can erase all other colors. When we select and move or completely delete a region with the selection tools, the empty space will automatically be filled with the second color, also known as the background color. Let's do a few small examples in the lower section. We will draw and prepare some basic shapes on our canvas to illustrate the different uses of the eraser tool. We use the eraser tool to draw and shape a large letter R using the methods we've just described. We place other letters and shapes that have been colored or will be colored later on our canvas. So, as promised, at this stage, we can provide more easily understandable examples of the different types of use of the eraser tool. For the color change, we choose a different background color with the eraser tool and create patterns inside the circle we created. In the same way, we can apply these operations to other letters and shapes. Since the color change takes place according to the color in the foreground color and the background color, the change takes place with whatever our background color is, and we can do this without disturbing the areas outside the foreground color. We use the right mouse button to change the color. We can erase the black contour lines of our multicolored small circular shape with a color change without touching the other colors. To do this, with the black background color selected, that is the target color is black, we change the background color to white, the color to be changed, and then delete it with the right mouse button. To change or manipulate a specific target color, even if the target color is among many colors, the color changing feature of the eraser tool provides a lot of practicality and convenience. As in previous studies, we recorded our work in specific phases. We can present our phases as a simple animation, that is a series of moving pictures that we can play in series on a slide. Thus, we have come to the end of this training. If you haven't seen it, we recommend you to watch the previous content we have shared in this series and the upcoming ones. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.